If you feel things are changing fast, well, it's because they are. We are in a transitional period. Just think about the most populated country in the world, China, seeing its first population decline in over six decades. Fossil fuels are no longer popular. In 2022 alone, 6.8 million of new energy vehicles were sold in China. Seeing a market share increase to 25.6%, almost doubled in just 12 months. Reducing the use of plastic bags, a product from petroleum, is now the worldwide agreement. Anxiety about population decline and embrace of new energy just mark people's cognition of renewable resources and circular economy at this point in time from two aspects. What are we actually doing and still can do at this point to support the regeneration of the resources which leads to our sustainable future? Speaking of the future, 2022 may even end up being remembered as the year the future arrived, not only because of breakthroughs in cold nuclear fusion or Chinese and American scientists joining forces to create a potential successor to silicon chips, but also thanks to the democratization and popularization of AI technology. Recently, an AI-generated piece has controversially won an art competition in the US. But before your social media feed was swamped with creepy AI-generated selfies, and that one writer friend started complaining about how ChatGPT will steal their job, AI was far from being a commonplace topic of discussion. Now, fear of obsolescence keeps writers, designers, starving artists awake at night as they imagine a dystopian world where even our imagination is obsolete. AI usually appeared in a physical form that is easier to imagine, the robot, doing human drudgery, unleashing human potential.
I will always follow my purpose.
Over the years, humankind has developed so many technologies that, by helping us, are also indulging our laziness. From apps that can deliver any type of food to your doorstep in just a few taps to live streaming that subverted existing supply chains and revolutionized the way rural producers connect with urban consumers, technology makes our lives significantly better and more convenient in thousands of visible and invisible ways. Many things that you are getting so used to have already been automated for years. Airplanes, subway trains, etc. Before we even realized, machine learning penetrated and arguably mastered those fields of creation and production that were commonly believed to be an exclusive domain of the human intellect, from writing to painting and programming. In China, robots like these are scattered around hotels and office buildings and are so commonplace that no one even takes selfies with them anymore. Macroscopic changes like the rise of AI and automation can be scary, and many expressed worry about the extent automation might impact our jobs and lives. Not this kind. More like this kind. AI and automation have become irreplaceable on the blueprint of the future. Take these two ambitious urban plans in 2021, for example. One is The Line, a 170 km long vertical city designed to be located in Saudi Arabia that's hoping to rethink everything we know about how people live, work, and have fun. In this imaginary city, automation will play a fundamental role, with AI monitoring the entire city and using predictive and data models to find ways to improve daily life for its citizens. American billionaire Mark Lohr has set out to build a city of the future in a desert region of the USA called Tolosa City, where fossil fuels-powered vehicles will be entirely prohibited, taking over by self-driving electric cars. If you think that's futuristic, or just some kind of game for visionary billionaires, well, think again. In Singapore, vertical farming has already impacted the lives of millions, as sustainable innovation is already providing fresh fruits and vegetables for local citizens. Singapore is a perfect example. Famously lacking resources to feed its 5.6 million population, more than 90% of food supply in the city relies on imports. While local agriculture only accounts for 1% of the total, thanks to automation, limited resources are now being regenerated in an innovative and efficient way.
We are developing a software platform, so we incorporate in machine learning because machine learning enables us to reach decisions quicker than any humans ever can.
When we shift our gaze from the top of Singaporean skyscrapers to the bottom of the ocean, other forms of automation are also making significant changes to the way we think about feeding the world. And getting rid of the plastic waste, such as single-use plastic generated daily by the food delivery industry.
But through our technology, after sort of relining or restructure the material, it creates certain functions that never exist before.
From production and distribution to regeneration, technology helps humans strike a balance between access to resources and ensuring their continued supply. Startups like ClearBot and eFishery often have fresher eyes to spot innovation opportunities, whereas giant companies or governments are often essential to make these visions come true. Ant Group, for example, one of China's largest mobile payment platform companies, wants to influence their users' behaviors. Their gamified platform, Ant Forest, incentivizes 650 million people to participate in low-carbon lives. Every time you unlock a shared bike with your phone or take public transportation, you accumulate points that can be used to actually plant 400 million trees in desertified areas. In Korea, starting 2023, consumers will be paid certain amounts of cashable carbon neutrality points for waste-reducing purchases, an automatic cleaning technology addressing existing pollution, efficient but sustainable farming methods that effectively utilizes resources, a fully degradable packaging material, attempts to change people's mindsets from behavior. These great moves at different stages of the circular economy are supporting the essence of sustainable development, regeneration. In another word, the security for the future. We used to think about the future as if it was something novel and distant from the present. Vertical farming, a whole world of food selection just several clicks away, and autonomous vehicles powered by AI are all living proof, showing that what once thought to be impossible to exist is now commonplace and standard. Of course, before that vision is realized, the future has already arrived, its distribution fragmented, with a clearer picture being formed in real time. Here's what human beings do. We try, we screw up, and then we learn from our mistakes to improve or start all over again. When we talk about sustainability, it is really about using the power of technology to bring futuristic imagination to reality. And if we do correctly, that reality is working within the circular system of regeneration, not breaking it. All that matters is that we hold the courage to face these evolving challenges and the imagination to solve new ones. Well, good luck and see you in the future. Wait, it's already here.